Overall, the results were statistically significant and clinically important in terms of a survival advantage in patients who received the combination. There was a 28% improvement in survival overall. This improvement was even greater in the first line setting. The two things we're seeing is that the 28% may improve even further because we haven't yet reached the median overall survival number in the experimental arm of ribociclib and fulvestrant, whereas we have reached the median endpoint for survival with the best available standard therapy, meaning the fulvestrant alone. So it sort of puts rest to the question of whether or not you should be holding these drugs, the CDK4/6 inhibitor, in this case ribociclib, until later in therapy and use it in the second line. We now know that it makes a significant impact when it's used in the first line in metastatic disease. So I think that's something that's potentially practice changing.